Hey guys. Fans rejoiced when longtime community pick Sora was revealed to be Super Smash Bros. Ultimate's final DLC combatant, but no one's asked how he got there. While fans are usually content with explaining Super Smash Bros. Roster by adhering to the long-held belief the series is the product of a child's imagination, Sora's appearance easily fits within the current Kingdom Hearts narrative. The heroic Keyblade wielder's displacement into Nintendo's brawler may just be another step in his journey. While Sora's been popularized alongside Disney acquaintances and locales, his inclusion in SSBU introduces the plucky warrior on his own. Sora's still able to utilize his skills with his Keyblade as well as some of the magic he's learned over the years, but it looks like he'll only be able to rely on his allies through the memories in his heart. Anyone familiar with Kingdom Hearts' story will recognize that many of these elements make sense when considering recent plot developments. Sora's addition in SSBU could be more than it appears. Kingdom Hearts' recent narrative has hinted that Sora is no longer in the Kingdom Hearts universe and is instead somewhere beyond the known realms of light and darkness. While it hasn't been made clear exactly where Sora is, officially being referred to as Quadratum, several pieces of evidence point to the hero crossing over into other Square Enix franchises. Fans know he's shown up in front of what looks like the World Ends with Yu's Shibuya 104 building, but that's about it. Everything started in Kingdom Hearts 3 by a chance encounter with another video game character. Sora's somewhat limited arsenal in SSBU can also be taken as evidence that he's there on account of his unintentional franchise-hopping adventure. If his time in Smash occurs somewhere between his sacrifice and his reappearance in Shibuya Quadratum, then that would explain why he's present without any of his allies, Disney-adjacent or otherwise. The same can be said for his limited ability and magic options. If Sora's disembodied heart spirit passed through the dimensional boundaries that separate video game universes, it makes sense that he wouldn't retain all his powers. Sora's Super Smash Bros. Inclusion has fans excited, but should they be pondering instead? Kingdom Hearts has set events into motion that offer plenty of support for Sora's cross-franchise appearance to be more than just DLC phenomena. While neither Square Enix nor Nintendo has mentioned anything about Sora's Smash appearance being a canon, it'd be a great twist to work into both franchises. That is all for now. Thank you so much for watching. Like if you like it. Dislike if you dislike it and subscribe if you subscribed it. Merry Christmas. Hey gamers. MattPlaySora7 here. Please consider joining my Discord server. It is totally free and you can catch up on my YouTube videos and even more information. Use the link here on in the description below to join my server. Also, I will be doing announcing merchandise releases, shoutouts, art tutorials and more. Be sure to join.